I'm Van.
I'm Sori.
That's Booby.
And Vita and Chip and Colby.
Vita shirts. Booby shirts on the way, y'all. I'm pretty excited. Pretty excited about Booby shirts.
I have to find a time to get that into the store. And then I need to figure out how to even show people where the store is. Because, like, there's like, a lot of gear. Like, the Sori Secret shirt, the one that's even better than this one, is now up in the store. And the Middle America gear is there, but I don't know how to tell people to get there.
Yeah, we'll figure it out.
So if you want to see behind the scenes what goes on around this house, this home, this crazy place that we live, check out my channel, My Sori Life.
Yep. And if you want to hear timely, topical, political commentary, check out my channel, Middle America Vin and Sori. Mm-hmm. We just did an expose on PolitiFact.
Yeah.
That's pretty interesting. That's
yep.
Pretty.
It's very informative.
Pretty damning expose yep. of PolitiFact. But if you just like music and you just like music reviews, then this is a place for you. So after the Queen.
And if you don't like lots of talking or long reviews, this is not the channel for you.
Right.
We'll see ya.
Don't do it. After the Queen thing that we did, a lot of people were talking about this one, the Somebody to Love. Was this Montreal 81?
Yeah, 1981 in Montreal live.
So,
and some people were saying, like, this totally changed. Like, one person said this, like, they don't even like the studio version now. That this is their go-to. Like, not that they don't like that at all, but that this is, like, so
I can
much
always
better.
Tell what type of band I'm dealing with when, based on how people react
to the live.
To the live thing.
How dare you with the live!
How dare you do the live one! Where we can actually hear their talent level or lack thereof. Okay, so this is Somebody to Love. This was 81. We had our timelines all screwed up last time. Yeah. The last one. Well, yeah. Because we're pretty ignorant about Queen. But I guess, so that he is 81. I'm pretty sure he died in the 80s.
Oh, my God.
But somebody in the previous video, not We Will Rock You. The most recent one we did. Oh, Bohemian Rhapsody.
Oh,
said,
yeah.
You guys got the timeline wrong, and da 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 da. I guess he hadn't even come out of the closet yet.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It was like 1975 or something like that.
There's got to be a place where we're able to, like, put our information.
I don't know this stuff, so I don't,
right,
know, I don't have a problem saying it, you know.
No, I'm saying, like, where people can read, like, about us or something like that to know, like, this is a journey we're taking, like, to metal. Does he look like a metalhead? I mean, you listen to some metal, but it wasn't like
I'm a metalhead.
You were not.
I am a metalhead.
You were not a metalhead.
Queen is not even a metal band. They're not even metal.
How many metal bands did you know about that you listened to on the regular?
Queen is not a metal band, period. Even if I was a metalhead.
Fine. Forget about Queen.
I am a metalhead.
But no, I'm not saying that you aren't now, but even back then.
What's back then?
Sure, whatever. He
Slipknot?
Didn't listen to a bunch of it. It was Slipknot. It was
the
Korn.
The dude from Slipknot said I was headbanging hardest in the front
fine.
Row.
Fine. How many
That's
bands
metal.
Did you listen to?
How many bands do you need to listen to be a metal band?
I'm just saying, he didn't know much about it.
All right.
You were, I thought by what you used to say that you knew what was going on. And then more and more I saw in the comments. Because
did you hear me talking? Did you hear me talking
about
any other bands?
Anything. So I was like,
did you hear me talk about anything other than Korn and
Slipknot? You were saying, and then I was like, oh well, this guy must know what he's talking about about metal. I would be asking you if you look at our early reviews. I'd be asking him, and you'll notice I don't do it as much anymore because I know you don't know as much as I thought you knew about it. You know, if it's Korn or Slipknot, you're like, you know what you're talking about, but. Like, there's so many genres of metal that...
This is not metal!
Whatever, babe! Whatever.
Queen is not metal!
You're getting sidetracked by just this one review. There's, like, bunches of them that you didn't know anything about.
I want to listen to this song, and I want to see this video.
You just don't want to carry on with the conversation that you know you're wrong.
I don't even understand why we're having this conversation, to be honest.
Go!
Full screen.
Somebody, can somebody find somebody Somebody love.
Yeah.
Okay, let's do it.
glad that it's over.
Man, I hope they don't block this one. Was this official? Was this like from the thingamajig?
I don't know.
Man, I hope they don't block it.
I mean, it's just incredible. It wouldn't surprise me if they did.
Damn.
Yeah. I don't know. I'll look it up later, but... Oh my gosh.
Man.
That has got to be on a greatest hits list. Like, it's gotta be. That's like...
Somebody! Oh.
It was this one.
No, I think we're gonna be okay. I think we're gonna be alright.
That is just such a great...
Oh, man. What a... Well, first of all, immediately it's gonna be like, whoa, he's an amazing singer, blah, blah. But the entire band!
The entire thing!
They all can sing!
Oh no, I know.
The backing... At first, I thought it was like a... what was it? The Pink Floyd thing where they had the girl in the background?
Uh-huh, yeah.
So I was like, oh, they brought some gospel singers or something on the stage or something.
But then it was a drummer.
They pulled back, it was a drummer, and I'm pretty sure the guitarist. I'm like, what? Like, all these dudes, the drummer has better vocals than, like, like, I don't know, 85% of the band's out right now.
That's wild.
I mean, just like...
What an incredible song. He has got such a voice, man.
This dude's like an honorary brother. He's got a lot of like soul in him.
Yeah.
He's like a soul singer in rock and roll. Like this dude.
Yeah.
Like, you could find him in a jazz bar somewhere. He's not Italian. I said he was Italian. I said maybe he's Italian because they were saying what were they saying in the other song? They said Mamma Mia.
Yo, yeah. That's
remember that?
Yeah.
They said Mamma Mia, and then they said Bismillah.
What is he? Or you don't know?
I think he's some version of Arabic something, actually. I forgot what he was. But wow. Wow, this dude is...
Wild.
He's a deep dude. But, I mean, the whole band is crazy.
The entire performance. And then, like, when he got back to the piano at the end and he took a drink, I said, okay, he's gonna do something with his voice here because...
Yeah.
He was just ending it, you know?
Right, right.
But he took a little swig there, and then he like went out and finished the rest of it. And then like when he was like took his fist and he banged on the piano, like even that was good. Like the whole thing, just incredible.
He's got a very first of all, this is a band live. Forget it.
They were knocking it out of the park. I could not believe how excellent they were.
Yeah, like that.
That's just wild.
And this is what this was 81. So all the sound tech. I mean, we're gonna see this at NAMM. All the sound technology and all the stuff.
What do you mean we're gonna see this at NAMM?
Well, the sound technology, because now I'm just starting to do some research. It's like the tech, the latest cutting edge tech.
Oh yeah.
Stuff for musicians. That's what you see at NAMM.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, my point is, this was the early '80s. They didn't have all the stuff now that you have to make yourself sound good.
Exactly.
So you just had to rely on complete raw
talent.
Either you're good or not.
Mm-hmm.
And these dudes, it's like I always say, like, you can walk around and be like, oh, I could do that.
Mm.
I could play that riff. Mm. I could, you know, whatever. But then you see other people and you're like...
I'm just going to sit back and bask in the glory of it.
Nobody can do what this guy is doing. And he's such a stage presence, you know. He's wearing a little Superman shirt. He's skinny as hell.
I know.
But he was prancing around,
like moving
he's prancing around fabulously on the stage.
Just the way that he was, I don't know. I felt like he was being himself, and I appreciated that.
He has such an endearing quality about him.
Yeah, he does.
Like a little boy type.
Yes.
Of thing. Yeah.
I thought the same thing.
But he's so powerful.
Yeah.
Like it's weird. Somebody said in the comments that he's like vocalists, like he's the greatest vocalist in rock and roll. So I'm like, okay, I got him and I've got Dio. Dio is still my favorite. But I haven't seen a Dio live video yet. Because
I think this guy's my favorite.
You know, you have powerful singers, but they're shrill.
Yeah.
Like Mariah Carey, my brother was a big Mariah Carey fan back in the day. And she used to hit these like ridiculously high notes, but it was just shrill. It was like, oh, okay, all right. Like, okay, you can hit the note. Good for you. But.
Yeah.
This is different. It's like pure, clean, creamy.
It was
smooth
start to finish. It was beautifully done.
This guy's, you could just tell the guy was like, all right, I'm going to, like, OD and give this guy, like, 70 shares of vocal excellence, and the rest of us get, like, 11. Thank you. We all get 11. This dude got, like, 70. He was out of this world. But like I said, the other musicians in the band were badasses themselves.
No, when that drummer was singing, I was like, jeez.
And he was maintaining. That's hard to do. That's not easy to do. I mean, good lord. I mean, we're gonna get into the lyrics because we're a lyric focused site, but it's just, I'm just blown away by the dude's ability to do this. I think some of it is that we've never been exposed to bands like this. Like, you've been to 2 live shows now. It was Behemoth. I mean, it's just a different type of metal.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, it's not, but again, this is more rock and roll. This is not metal, but, you know, it's, but man, I could see why these guys, I always said to myself, like, you know, discovering Pantera late, mm-hmm. and I'm like, oh man, I wish I'd had Pantera coming up. I'm glad that I wasn't a teenager in the 80s or late 70s listening to these guys. Because it would have crushed me to lose him.
Mm-hmm. What happened to him?
He died of AIDS. Yeah, he didn't make it out of the 80s, I don't think. I'm not sure.
Oh, gosh.
I don't know when he died. But it would have crushed me to lose this guy. Mm-hmm. Freddie Mercury.
That's why when you said we're going to see this at NAMM.
91.
I was like, wait.
He died in 91. Still,
but I thought that you had said that he was dead, and so that's why I was like, what are you talking about? And then you were talking about the quality of the...
He died in 91, so this, he had 10 years left from the shooting of this video. Isn't that crazy to think? Yeah, it would have crushed, because he just seems like a person that you just get attached to,
mm-hmm.
and that you want to root for him, you want to see him win.
Mm-hmm.
And then, boom, he's taken from us, but... You could look at it like he was taken from us, or you could look at it like God loaned him to us and gave, you know, he mm-hmm. gave us his beautiful music.
Yeah.
I wonder if he helped people to kind of embrace themselves and be themselves.
Oh, I would think so. Because he's kind of nerdy there, awkward and...
Yeah, he's...
But he's doing his thing.
Like. Yeah, he's not the proto-masculine type guy, but he was... It shows a different way that you could be masculine, I think. Because it's like... There's no doubt that he's got a powerful vocal range.
Yeah.
So you can't sleep on him. The dude is absolutely rock and roll, but he's not your standard masculine guy. I think he could. He probably helped a lot of people to be mm-hmm. able to embrace who they were
mm-hmm.
without, you know, jumping off a bridge.
Yeah.
You know, just by his essence.
Yeah.
Ugh. So,
unbelievable.
Celebrate the big homie. Can anybody find somebody?
Find me somebody to love. I liked that because I thought, you know, like a lot of times people make it about themselves, like, you know, that they want to be loved. But he's saying, can somebody find somebody that I can love? Like, I want to love somebody.
Yeah.
What?
No, it's an interesting, instead of saying somebody to love me, somebody for him to love. But, I mean, I think that's the thing about love is that nobody wants to just... have somebody dote over them. They want somebody that they can express love to as
well.
Not
everybody. Some people just want to be doted over. Not everybody wants to have that mutual expression of love.
Yeah, I mean, I haven't met them, but I'm sure there's people out there like that. Each morning I get up, I die a little, can barely stand on my feet. Take a look at yourself in the mirror and cry. Take a look in the mirror and cry. Lord, what you're doing to me. I spent all my years in believing you. But I just can't get no relief.
We apologize if you can hear our kids in the other room.
Guys!
We're playing Fortnite very loudly.
Pink! So, verse 1 looks like a prayer almost.
Yeah.
Because he's asking God to... He wants relief, and the relief is to find somebody that he can express his love to.
Did you say he hadn't come out at this point? Is that what you said?
I don't know what the timeline is.
Do you think it has anything to do with that?
Well, he wasn't gay. From what I'm getting bi. He was bi.
Oh, okay.
What I'm getting from the comment section, he was bi. He wasn't gay. And so, I mean, So I think it's probably, I don't know, he's just feeling lonely, I think.
Yeah.
Can anybody find me somebody to love? I work hard every day of my life. I work till I ache my bones. At the end of the day, I take home my hard-earned pay all on my own. I get down on my knees and I start to pray till the tears run from my eyes, Lord. Very, very simple, but very, you know, deep to the human soul.
Yeah, there's a lot of feeling in it.
And you can tell that he means it when he's singing it.
Yeah, yeah. That was interesting when he said about, like, I take home my hard-earned pay all on my own. Like, it almost even sounds like he wants somebody to spend his money with, too.
Well, yeah. You know? Well, yeah. That's...
I've never, ever heard anybody say that.
Yeah.
That's a first, too.
Yeah, like, what's the... Okay, you've got millions. By yourself. Mm-hmm. Who's watching that documentary with Kurt Cobain, one of them. And he had this million-dollar home in Washington somewhere. And then he would hole himself up in his closet and with his guitar.
Mm-hmm.
Or he would go to the seedy hotel somewhere.
I know, and that other guy said he knows tons of metal guys that do that.
Yeah, they'll stay in this little closet area.
He said they'll buy a TV, they'll set it on the box they bought the TV on and just...
Watch the TV in a little room for years.
Yeah.
So...
They don't spread out over the whole...
I think, like, when you're a real musician like that, you got so much soul, like, the money is I mean, they like it, and they like spending it, sure, but it's not, it doesn't do for them what they want it to do. It's mm-hmm. really, what it comes down to is if you find somebody that loves you and you can love them, that's important.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's a precious thing.
Yeah.
And he's praying, it's so interesting. He's praying for somebody that he can have in his life that, I wonder if he ever found...
Wondering the same thing.
I wonder if you ever found that person, you know?
Yeah.
It must be extremely hard. See, if I was a rock star, I would, like, find some girl I broke up with in high school or something and try to rekindle it if you were, like, really wanted a relationship. Because how could you know after you become rich and famous? Unless you were with another rock star, then you could say, okay, or another famous person, then you could say, well...
I know, look how that was for... Kurt Cobain and Courtney.
Yeah.
Didn't look like it was working too good.
Well, it's not a very healthy relationship for them, for either one of them.
Right.
It's just very interesting. Well, you got a guy like... This is kind of a... You know, Adam could do this song. Like, Adam from the Bible.
Oh, right? Yeah.
Depending on how long it was between when he was created and when he was created, because he, you know...
Well, he basically said, finally...
Yeah, he did.
At last.
Yeah, when he finally met Eve, he said
there was
last.
Enough time where he was like, oh, there was some relief when she got there.
Yeah, it's part of me is like, yeah, your relationship with God should be such that, you know, you express your love to Him. You don't need another person.
But,
like when my previous relationship was over, I was like, all right, that's it. Me and God will go backpacking forever. Like I was done with relationships. So part of me feels like, shouldn't you be able to subsist on your walk with God alone? Then I think to myself, well, you know, Paul said in Corinthians, what, 1 Corinthians 7, not everyone has that gift.
Right.
Of being able to be alone. So, I always go back and forth on that, because I don't know where that line is.
Well, maybe you think that you have that gift, and you're just not exercising it?
Probably. Probably.
So maybe that's why you go back and forth, because I think to myself, nope.
But you definitely...
I do not have that gift.
Right.
Nope.
You'd have to be in some relationship somehow, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I think it would depend on how old I was, but not at this age.
What do you mean, like if you were 85?
No, if I was like in my 50s or something, like I feel like I'd just be like... There's things that I want to do that... You can't do as much.
Huh? In your 50s?
No, like, in your 50s, like, there's things that I would want to do. Like, I always want to be where you are. But But if I was single, then I wouldn't want to necessarily be where, you know what I mean? Like, I could be, then I'd be like, oh, okay, what do I want to do? Like, I want to be able to do, like, women's conferences and different things like that. But I don't want to do a whole conference and be gone from you for a week or a half a week or something. So, like, then I think to myself, well, if I was in my 50s and I didn't have anybody, then that would be the perfect time to do those things that I really wanted to do.
Yeah, and you could tell the ladies, hey, ladies, just wait till you're in your 50s.
What
then
do you mean?
Have, then you can have your emotional independence. good song, right down to the human soul, though. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable song.
What was the last little bit there? Hold on, stop. Ooh, right over here.
Got no feel, I got no rhythm, I just keep losing my beat. I'm okay, I'm alright. I ain't gonna face no defeat. I just gotta get out of this prison cell. Someday I'm gonna be free, Lord.
So do you think he's thinking that freedom is in the relationship? Or freedom is what? What do you think he's thinking there?
Well, the previous
prison cell.
In the bridge, he said, I try and try and I try and I try, but everybody wants to put me down. They say I'm going crazy. They say I got a lot of water in my brain. No, I got no common sense. I ain't got nobody left to believe. So it looks like people are putting him down. People are saying that's probably why, in his mind, he's probably alone, because people keep putting him down and nobody believes in him. And so he's gonna...
How can nobody believe in him? That's so crazy to me, like...
Well, he's probably thinking about his upbringing. You know, growing up, he's an immigrant, he's got buck teeth, he's flamboyant. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of these rock stars would be absolute zeros if they weren't rock stars
in the
social sense of zeros.
I know.
So they come, even though they have all this, their status changes, they're still them. Mm-hmm. So they don't, their emotional memory doesn't follow with their rock star status. It takes them a while to realize, wait a second, you know, and then they cop an attitude and people wonder why. It's like, they've been beaten down their entire life. Now they're getting a little bit of fame and a little bit of respect. Of course they're going to swing the other way.
Right.
How can you be mad at them for that? You think Maynard be getting all in lately? Have you seen him? He doesn't strike me as the type of dude that would be swimming in women if he was just a regular Joe.
Isn't that, you're going to make people angry, isn't that what I said? I was like, how is that guy saying he's slaying all the women when he's like skinny like that? What was that? We just talked about the Patreon thing. Well, who was that?
That was a dude from AC/DC. I wasn't mad at you about it. I just knew people were going to
people were mad. But
even in the Patreon review, the people were mad.
No, people were mad.
What do you give the song?
Oh, 10.
Definitely a 10 for sure.
10.
This song is a 10. I guarantee you, I probably would have given it like a 9 or maybe even an 8.9 if I'd have heard it on the studio versus hearing it on the...
and seeing him and stuff.
Versus seeing it live.
Yeah.
Definitely the live pushed it up for me, for sure.
Wow.
I mean, I'll eventually go and look at the studio version, but the live one was unbelievable.
I wish I had a list of the songs that... Like, I've given 10s to things because they're like... I think that they're like, wow, that's a 10.
Right.
But there's some stuff that I'm like clapping at the end and I'm like, or yes, fucking love. I wish that I had a list of the ones that I did all of that with. Yeah,
Kai probably,
I think he
has
knows.
Some, I don't know.
I'll ask him.
But good song.
Anyway.
Rest in peace to the big homie. He's with the Ain't Self, inshallah. Vin out.
Story out.
Gone. Somebody to love. Somebody to love.